The Wildlife Trust of India initiated rapid action projects in 1999 for swift and urgent addressal of conservation emergencies. Joining hands with the David Shepherd Wildlife Foundation, through RAPs, we have supported activities which involve conservation of key species including Asian elephants, rhinos and tigers, along with other critical wildlife whose conservation is of utmost importance. We have conducted a wide range of RAPs involving local communities in conservation and aiding activities such as conflict mitigation, anti-poaching and rescue and rehabilitation. On the roster of RAPs are routine rescue and veterinary services. Ganga, the smooth-coated otter, is a case point. Rescued as a month-old pup from poachers and hand-raised by two biologists, Ganga was slowly acclimatized and allowed to interact with wild otters at Vikramshila Gangetic Dolphin Sanctuary in Bihar. He was finally accepted by a family of wild otters and was thereafter monitored to ensure his successful return to the wild. In 2007, significant achievement was made when an RAP ensured India's first wild reintegration of elephants. Rescued from illegal possession in Arunachal Pradesh, three young elephants were cared for by WTI staff and regularly taken for forest walks for interaction with wild elephant herds. Continuous monitoring after their acceptance by the herd proved that the young had successfully readapted to life in the wild. In 2008, WTI joined hands with two local organizations to install low-voltage power fences to prevent entry of wild animals into Kuthori, a village in Assam, and minimize conflict. Volunteers were engaged to monitor the functioning of the solar-powered fence periodically to prevent depredation by wild animals. Human-wildlife conflict has significantly reduced in the area since the installation of the fence. In 2010, through another REP, an early warning system was installed in Todibari, a farming community in North Bengal, to help prevent crop depredation by elephants. The early warning system comprises of a series of trip wires which trigger alarms which in turn alert the villagers. An outer ring of pungent chili plantations which overwhelms the scent of paddy and thorny lime bushes was set up as a physical barrier. Todibari now records a significant increase in crop production. In 2008, while the increase in number of tigers in the Nilgiri Plateau was a cause for celebration, the numbers also led to pressure on the endangered Asiatic water buffaloes, bred and considered sacred by the Toda community of Tamil Nadu. A compensation scheme was put into place to ensure speedy relief in cases of cattle kills by tigers. This has greatly encouraged the Toda communities towards safeguarding not only their traditions but also of the tigers. Highways passing through protected areas are one of the greatest threats posed to Indian wildlife. At Bandipur, RAP sanctions enforced a speed limit through placement of barricades and signage along a 12.5 km stretch of highway, greatly reducing road kills, showing how small yet timely measures can help address wildlife issues and prevent them from flaring up. As a ceremonial rite of passage into adulthood, the Nishi community of the state of Arunachal Pradesh practices adorning headgear with hornbill beads to signify virility and a symbol of status. This led to an alarming decline in the populations of the Great Indian Pied, the Oriental Pied, the Rufous Neck and the Reed Hornbills. In 2001, WTI, in association with the State Forest Department and local organizations with funds provided by DSWF, formulated and popularized fiberglass hornbill beads as an alternative to natural ones. Several locals were trained to fabricate the synthetic beads to replace the demand for the real beads. The artificial beads have since then been widely accepted by the Nishi community and emerged as a viable solution to the problem. Gangetic dolphins in Bihar have been openly killed to process their fat for usage as catfish bait in an angling method unique to the state. In 2003, as an alternative, the RAP proponent suggested the use of fish scraps as an effective attractant. The project demonstrated the process of extracting oil from fish scraps for use among local fishermen and initiated a major move towards popularizing an alternative over the use of dolphin oil. Regular anti-poaching patrols around protected areas are vital in our quest to curb poaching of wild animals. this anti-poaching staff needs to be equipped with the right gear to perform the daily patrolling duties effectively. Over the years, DSWF has funded RAPs where we have equipped the anti-poaching staff with essential field gear and equipment which would aid them in their anti-poaching initiatives. Other essentials like bicycles, generators, gas connections and water pumps ensuring water supply for wildlife and forest staff have also been provided through our RAPs. This is your chance to be a part of the conservation movement in India and help wildlife in distress. Support a rapid action project in India today. For more information, log on to www.wti.org.in and www.davidshepherd.org.